All right, this is Absolute Radio at this year's Big Day Out Festival. My name is Ben Jones and Temper Trap are here. We've got Lorenzo, we've got Toby. Good to see you. How are you?
Good.
Yeah, we're great.
We're in your hometown. You spent a lot of time in London recording the album and now we're in your neck of the woods. Put it this way, it's a damn sight better than London right now.
Yeah, it's nice and warm and it's actually probably the perfect weather for the day. So we've had very hot weather since we've been on this tour. So
I heard the Sydney Big Day Out was just ridiculous.
It was 40 degrees at least both days. And then the second day there was some kind of apocalyptic dust hurricane followed by a thunderstorm. So
that was probably part of Muse's sort of set though, wasn't it? I know they go for the big sort of stage shows. But listen, it's nice to be here in Australia. Did you play any of the UK festivals this year?
Yeah, we played Reading, Leeds and Glastonbury, Latitude.
So most of them?
Yeah.
Yeah. How do these festivals differ from our festivals back home?
Yeah, Sunshine number one. I guess Big Day Out because it's a sort of, you know, there's seven shows, so there's a little bit of, you get that chance to develop a bit of a camaraderie with the other bands and it kind of becomes like everyone hanging out and stuff, whereas the Glastonbury and stuff, and because we were kind of in and out, so often we'd be at those festivals for some total of about 5 hours before we'd be back in the car and shipped off to the next location. So it's nice to be able to kind of have a bit of relax and enjoy some other bands.
I mean, this is hometown for you, so I guess it's all eyes on you guys today.
No, it's great to play in your hometown. You know, we've had some good, we did a couple of side shows in Melbourne while we've been here, and it's just fantastic to have your family and friends in the crowd and have that kind of hometown atmosphere.
But are you aware of the level of popularity for you guys now in the UK?
We played our last show at Coco before we came back, and you know, it was quite nice. We played our very first show in London at Coco to, I don't know, a few people at an NME night, and then to finally sell it out was pretty big. So I don't know if it's progressed any further from there, but yeah, it was quite surprising.
Do you prefer those sort of small Coco size venues, or do you like the big festival shows?
I think they've both got their advantages, but if I had to pick one, I kind of like more the theatre style show. You've still got like enough of a crowd there that there's amazing energy, but it still has a personality, whereas sometimes the festival huge crowds, they're just kind of like a seething mass of people going crazy.
We're only in Melbourne for about a week, so we're trying to see as much of it as possible. We went out to the Yarra Valley. I did the hot air ballooning over the city yesterday, which, as someone who suffers from vertigo, let me tell you, was quite an experience. Where should we go see? I mean, you guys have been here most of your lives, I guess. Where are the good places to go check out?
There's a place called Acme, which is in Federation Square, which is, what is it, the Australian Centre for Moving Images.
Really good Dennis Hopper exhibition on there right now. Food, kind of the Lygon Street, if you kind of like Italian food, yeah, and stuff.
Or anywhere down Flinders Lane, basically. There's heaps of good restaurants and cafes and bars. Because we have a big laneway culture, so you can basically walk down any laneway and you'll find like an interesting little cafe or bar or something like
basically
that.
Basically, it's like Brighton, but on a much, much bigger scale. What does Australia Day mean to you?
It means the day that we invaded Australia and started, you know, ruining Aboriginal people's lives.
You are the first person to give a vaguely historical answer to that, because when we vox pop people in Federation Square yesterday, the main answer was getting shit-faced. Yeah. Really, that was the main answer.
Well, yeah, no, that's what it is. It's basically throwing a few snags on the barbie, getting a slab and hanging out with your mates and listening to the Hottest 100. That's basically what most people do.
What is the inspiration for your band? Who were you listening to prior to maybe getting in the band and hopefully starting a band in the first place?
Between the four of us, we have pretty kind of different tastes, but the bands that kind of we all really liked are bands like Radiohead, U2, Arcade Fire, TV on the Radio, stuff like David Bowie as well.
Who should we go see? Because we're obviously trying to keep an ear out for the next Temper Trap, the next Aussie band that are going to do well. I mean, Powderfinger are obviously huge over here, but yet in the UK, they don't seem to have taken off. Anyone else you would recommend?
Young bands coming up, Tame Impala. I know they've played a few shows in the UK. They're really worth checking out. And a really other young band that's just kind of coming through called The Middle East.
All right. When are you coming back to the UK?
I'll be back in the UK on the 12th, and Toby, you're going to be back there on the 14th.
14th. Feel free to meet us at the airport and give us a lift back to Hackney. Thank
you. Is this for fun or is this for live shows?
It's for shows, and you know, we're kind of based over there now, so we've got to go and make sure that the house hasn't been robbed like it was before we left. So,
I'm laughing, and I thought you were joking. I apologize for my insincerity. Listen, good to see you. Great weather, and always good to get you guys on the radio.